starring in Swing Out, Sweet Land, with Anne Margaret, Lucille Ball, Jack Benny, Dan Blocker, Roscoe Lee Brown, Glenn Campbell, Johnny Cash, Roy Clark, Bing Crosby, Phyllis Diller, the Doodletown Pipers, Lorne Green, Celeste Holm, Bob Hope, Michael Landon, Dean Martin, Ross Martin, Greg Morris, David Nelson, Rick Nelson, Hugh O'Brien, Dan Rowan and Dick Martin, William Shatner, Red Skelton, Tommy Smothers, Leslie Uggams, and Dennis Weaver.
The bad news of the 1800s came in the form of a pretty rough argument, because for the first time in our lives, we were having a family fight. This is Appomattox, where it supposedly all ended. The tombstone reads, Civil War, rest in peace. Born 1861, died pretty soon, I hope. I wish we had more time to talk about some of the many wonderful things that have happened since you and I were born, but the old clock on the wall's got a beat on me. Now I guess I have just enough time to thank the wonderful Budweiser family for bringing us into your homes, and my thanks to all the beautiful people in front and back of the camera who are brought together tonight by their own goodwill and love of country. I'm a lucky fella. For many reasons. lucky that I was brought up to believe in a lot of things I found worthwhile. I believe in common decency, without which no society or goodwill can exist. I believe in my country, my family, my fellow man, and my God. I believe in straight talk and freedom with an accent on the free, which is still the best four-letter word I know. I believe in giving a fella a second, even a third chance. But keep your eye on him. I believe the moon's a nice place to visit, but I wouldn't want to live there because this country on this planet is man's last chance to make a go of it for humanity. And I believe there's time in my life and yours to get this country in such shape that God'd be proud of it. I believe your kids and mine are just you and me getting a second crack at the world. And our job is to see that they don't make all the mistakes we did and don't invent too many of their own. I believe 99% of them are a credit to their folks, a pride to their country, and deserve a pat on the backs from all of us for being what they are and not waving a white flag at life. I believe in hope for people of all ages, that equal opportunity is based on equal obligation. And speaking of opportunity, American opportunity has no limits, has been known to knock more than once. How about you very young people who see a tough life ahead? Well, when Lee surrendered to Grant at Appomattox, Booker T. Washington was a 9-year-old slave. Yet by the time he was 28, he became president of Tuskegee Institute. And at 8 months, Neil Armstrong took his first small baby step toward mankind and fell flat on his face. At 6 years old, Mickey Mantle was settling for a base on balls. At 7, Wilt Chamberlain nailed a practice hoop over his garage without a ladder. And at 8, Charles Lindbergh was flying a kite, wondering how it'd feel to be up that high. At 9, Burt Bacharach was thinking the piano lessons would never end. How many of you are pushing 50 and complaining that the country is going to hell? Crispus Attucks was in his 40s when he died on State Street in Boston, fighting for the freedom that we share. And John F. Kennedy was 44 when he asked not what his country could do for him, but what he could do for his country. And how many of you over 65 are just settling down now to rest after a busy life? Well, a fellow by the name of Eisenhower, who had already lived one lifetime as a soldier, was reelected to the presidency when he was 67 years young. Well, by now I've made my point, or I never will. Oh, there's one other thing. Every man and woman or child I've ever known, met, seen, or heard of wants one thing more than anything else in the world. And that one thing is tomorrow. Tomorrow, that's the only thing any of us have going for us. And I believe this. If tomorrow, all of us, every single one of us, gets out of bed and says, "This is my country, and I'm going to do good for it," we'll make the greatest step forward since a pilgrim's foot found Plymouth Rock. Tomorrow, remember, this is my country and I'm going to do good for it. Just might work. We'll never know unless we give it a fair try. Oh, yeah, and there's one other thing I'll say tomorrow because I say it every day of my life. God bless America.
Stand beside her and guide her through the night with a light from above. From the mountains to the prairies,
to the ocean wide with love.
God.
trees, to the prairies,
to the ocean, white with foam.
God bless America,
my.